Hi everyone, welcome to this month's episode. We're gonna dive right in and talk about what we saw in July and what you can expect in September. So for July, the housing market was incredibly strong. It was actually the strongest month we've had this year. We saw that sales volume was up 24% since last year, which is quite a stifling number. I'd say the main reason for this would be the fact that our spring came a little later than usual this year, so a lot of people were not listing their homes until end of June, beginning of July, and therefore there were a lot of buyers out there who were waiting for those homes to come up. I would also say it's because of the fact that our interest rates are really low right now and under 3%, which is fantastic for a lot of you looking. And so that's kind of the reason that we had such a great month. Now, if I'm going to dive right into the numbers and look at home types, what we saw in Toronto specifically was that the average sale for a home was $876,389, which was up 4.7% since last year. Number of sales was 19,044, which was up 6% year to date. And if we look at how many months of inventory are available, we're sitting at 1.69, which means, of course, that Toronto would sell out in 1.69 months. Quite low, actually, for what we've been averaging lately. Now let's look at condos. Condos are also remaining incredibly strong. We see that the average sale price is $627,927, which is up 7.8%. And then we also see that there were 1,617 condo sales, which is up 14.3%. All in all, condos are still doing extremely well, I would say, especially as I've always mentioned, renters, and this time of year is a bit of a renting frenzy. So if you are thinking about investing your money into an investment condo that you'd like to rent out, definitely come talk to me and I can tell you all the benefits about being a landlord. Anyway, thanks for tuning in. My email is ashley.smith@royalpage.ca if you have any questions. Take care.